I'm Julie Goodnight, and I want to show you how I'm going to introduce a new bit to the horse. In this case, it's the Myler three-ring combination bit. And the horse I'm going to use today is Rusty. He is a six-year-old quarter horse gelding. He's pretty well trained, and he's been ridden up until now in the French link snaffle. So before I'm going to introduce any kind of new bridle or bit to the horse, I want to make sure, or even just bridle the horse in general, I want to make sure I'm well organized. I don't want to get up here right into the horse's face where he's a little uncomfortable and then be flipping equipment around. And so I just want to make sure I'm holding my bridle in an organized fashion. I like to put the reins over my shoulder to just get them out of the way. Another thing I might do is put the reins over the neck of the horse to hold him with the reins while I bridle. But before I do that, I just want to get an approximation of how this is going to fit him. So holding the head stall wide like it would sit on the horse and holding the bit wide as it's going to be in his mouth, I'm just going to kind of hold it up next to his head here and see if I'm in the ballpark region. And I would like to err on having the bridle a little bit looser rather than tighter. If I put it on and it's snug, in order to loosen it, I have to make it even tighter when I run that buckle up. So I always want to err on the side of the headstall being a little bit large or a little bit loose. And then I'm going to undo my keepers. We've got this on an English headstall. And I want to undo my keepers so that if I have to do some adjustment once it's on, sometimes I might go up a little bit, down a little bit, just kind of to see what the horse needs. So I'm going to let this one down and just make sure the keepers are undone. So now I'm pretty sure this is going to be plenty big for the horse, and just get his nose over here where I can reach it. So I'm going to go ahead and slip the halter off. And I got two choices here. I can keep the halter around his neck to help me control the horse while I bridle him. But I don't really think I need that. Rusty's pretty good boy here, so I think I can just hold him with my arm. So I'm going to bridle with the combination bridle pretty much like I would with any bridle, except for the nose band has to be guided onto the face of the horse. All right, so I've got my bridle organized and the nose band is unfastened. And so I'm just going to bridle him as normal. And I just have to kind of use my fingers to make sure the nose band stays out of his mouth and up on top of his nose. So I'm just going to take my time. This mouthpiece is quite different from the French link snaffle. And he's opening his teeth just big enough. He's opening just the amount that French link snaffle was, and that's pretty normal. So whatever, and now I'm just holding up pressure on this bit while he sort of settles with the thing in his mouth. But whatever bit your horse was used to, he was very used to that bit. It's been in his mouth quite a few times. He knows the exact shape and feel. He, just like Rusty was doing, he'll often only open his teeth just to the exact diameter of that bit. And that's what he did. It's just that this bit had a different shape, which required him to open his teeth just a little bit more to accommodate the port. And so he was like, oh my God, what do I do? That's not the right width. So I just want to slow down, take my time, hold my ground there, wait for him to open his mouth as he did. So all this time that he was fussing and fiddling with that, bit new mouthpiece he was feeling out, all that time I was just holding upward pressure on the headstall to hold that bit high up in his mouth so it didn't clink on his teeth. And I just waited. I don't need to get the ears in right away. I just waited whatever time it took for him to kind of calm down, settle down a little bit.